Hey guys, what's up? Today I'm going to share some of my personal tips on how to cram for your exams. Of course, I don't encourage you guys to cram for every exam, but let's be real here. We all cram every once in a while, right? That's why I thought it would be a good idea to share some of my cramming tips with you guys. Keep in mind that these are my personal tips, and obviously what worked for me may not work for you. Also, please make sure to read the description box first before you guys ask me any questions, because I put all the frequently asked questions there, yet there are still so many people asking me the same questions over and over again on every video, even though the answers are right there. So make sure to check out the description box first to find all the information you might need. Okay then, enough rambling, let's start with the first tip. Make sure you've eaten well before you start studying, because it'll be hard to concentrate if you have an empty stomach. Get rid of all distractions. Turn off your phone, your television, your Wi-Fi, and get rid of everything else that might distract you from studying. Make sure you have everything you need with you on your desk. Books, stationaries, a glass of water, etc. Now that your preparation is done, it's time to start studying. Understand, not memorize. If you understand what you're learning, then it doesn't matter if your teacher happens to twist the exam questions to confuse you, you will still not fall into their trap. If you blindly memorize without understanding anything, then you won't be able to solve the problems if the questions happen to be a bit different from the one you've memorized. Remember, the key is to understand what you're learning first before you try storing anything inside your brain. If you understand the concept, then you will be able to find a way to solve the problems. If you only memorize without understanding anything, then you'll only be able to answer the questions if they are the same to the ones you've memorized. Focus on the big stuff first. Realistically speaking, since you're studying a few days or maybe the night before the exams, it'll be impossible to memorize everything in your textbook all at once. So instead of getting preoccupied over the tiny details, try understanding the concepts first. If you understand the main concepts, then you'll also understand the connection between the topics, and you'll be able to answer your exam questions better than if you merely memorize the tiny details without understanding the main concepts at all. Remember, your time is limited, so it's best to learn about the big things that will most likely come up on the test instead of the tiny details that have a smaller chance of being questioned on the test. Only move on to the details if you're done studying the main concepts. Identify the key points. They're usually placed at the beginning or the end of a chapter. People easily make the mistake of reading the whole chapter yet not knowing what they've read by the end of it. So instead of wasting time reading the whole chapter, read the definition of the key topics and do your best to understand and memorize them. It'll be a lot easier than to try memorizing the whole chapter. Read your notes. If you've taken notes in each of your classes, now is the perfect time to review them. The notes that your teacher gave you will most likely be on your test. If you slacked off in class and haven't written down any notes at all, then ask your friends if you can copy their notes. I used to always trade notes with my friends back in uni, and it was very beneficial to both of us. Use mind maps. I've talked about this in my how to take notes video. Mind map is a great way to memorize and understand the connection between the concepts you're studying. Also, it'll be easier to memorize things if you're using visuals than if you're merely using words. Make a summary of what you've learned. Writing down a summary will help you narrow things down, and it'll be easier to learn from your summary instead of rereading the textbook over and over again. So write down the keywords and their definitions on your notebook or your flashcards, then read and memorize them every chance you get. Record your own explanation. Read the definition of each keyword out loud and record them on your phone or on your laptop. Then, save that recording into your device and listen to it every chance you get. You can listen to it when you're going out, when you're eating, and maybe before going to bed. You'll be able to memorize your lessons in no time. Hey Ray, what's up?
The mollusks compose the large phylum of invertebrate animals known as the mollusca.
What? If you need more memorizing techniques, then watch my How to Memorize Fast and Easily video. I'll put a link to it in the description box below if you'd like to check it out, along with my studying playlist if you want to watch all those videos before you begin studying. Answer the questions in your textbook. There's a good chance that those questions are going to be put on the test, so make sure to complete them as soon as you finish studying the current chapter. Test yourself. Answer the questions in your textbook for the second time, but this time, don't take a look at your notes. You can also create your own questions and answer them afterwards, or write down the definition of the keywords you've learned without reading your textbook or your notebook. That way, you'll know for sure if you haven't memorized those things as well as you thought you had. Repeat this step until you can answer all the questions with ease. Remember that practice will give you better results than just reading the materials over and over. If you're cramming for math or physics, then there's no other choice but to do the exercises in your textbook. You can't understand maths just by memorizing the formulas. You have to practice and solve as many math problems as you can in order to get good at it. If your textbook doesn't have enough questions in them, then search for other textbooks in the library or ask your friends if they have any tiny practice sheet that you can copy and solve at home. If you're having troubles with your studies, then don't be afraid to ask your friends for help. You can learn a lot of things from them, and you can even trade your knowledge with them. Maybe your friend is good at math, so you can ask your friend to teach you. And maybe you're good at history, so you can teach your friend in return. Remember that you're not alone on this, and you can always ask for help if you need to. Don't study in a group if none of you know what you're doing. Based on my experience, if you study with a group of friends who don't know anything about what you're studying, then you'll only be wasting your time. So unless one of you is an expert on the subject you're studying and is able to teach the others, then it's best to study on your own. If you already understand what you're studying, then you can teach your friends during your group study. Teaching others is a great way to keep your memories intact, and it will also help you understand the lessons better. Make sure you have your stationaries, calculator, student ID card, and everything else you might need, and put them inside your bag. You don't want to prepare them the next day in case you wake up late and don't have enough time to prepare them before you leave for school. You might forget to take one of them with you, and you'll panic as soon as you arrive in class, which will break your concentration during the test. So make sure to prepare everything you need the night before. Prepare the clothes you're going to wear. Whether it's your school uniform or your casual clothing, make sure to have them prepared so you don't have to waste time stressing about what you're going to wear the next morning. Leave your next morning as empty as possible so you'll be able to relax a bit before you leave for school and take your test. Get a good night's sleep. Don't study until late at night. You won't be able to retrieve the information you've stored in your brain if you don't have enough rest. So make sure to sleep well so you'll feel refreshed the next day and ready to tackle your test. So those were some of the tips I could share with you guys. I hope you found them useful. Remember that you shouldn't always cram for your test, as it's not an effective way to study. You'll most likely forget what you've learned as soon as you've finished taking your tests. So make sure to study regularly every day so you'll be able to store all the lessons you've learned in your long-term memory. If you guys have any other cramming tips you'd like to share with us, then feel free to leave them in the comments below. By the way, I've received a lot of comments asking me to make a room tour video! All I can say is, please be patient, guys. The room tour video will be up as soon as I'm done redecorating my room. I've had a lot of things to take care of in real life, so I haven't got the time to finish redecorating yet. I'm not postponing this video to leave you guys hanging and to torment you guys mentally. I'm not that evil, so please just wait a bit more. It'll be up before you know it. Also, for those of you guys who don't know yet, I have a second channel now. I'll be uploading random videos, including gaming videos, using my native language there. But I will also put English subtitles so you guys can still understand what I'm saying. So if you guys are interested, you can check it out by clicking here. I will also leave the link to it in the description box below. Lastly, thank you very much to those of you guys who have followed me on my social medias. If you haven't and if you want to, the links are also in the description box below. So that's all from me today, guys. Thank you very much for watching this video, and thank you for those of you who have subscribed to me. If you haven't, please be sure to click on the shiny subscribe button below. Don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends if you enjoyed watching it. And I will see you on my next one. Have a nice day, everyone. Bye-bye.